right, sweetheart. I know. I'm sorry.
Laura, you all right, love?
Oh, Pat, I'm so sorry. Did he wake you up?
That's what babies are for, isn't it? You're teething again, young man.
I've run out of teething gel.
Oh, well, nip down to the chemist. I'll keep an eye on him for you.
Right.
Laura, you haven't got the money, have you? Can't you ask the welfare if they can give you an emergency payout or something?
I've still got to pay them back after last week, thanks to Janine.
Yes, well, I'm sure they'd understand if you explained the situation.
Oh, Pat, I can't go crawling back in there begging for handouts. It's just not me.
Well, in that case...
Look, Pat, I can't. You've been more than generous as it is.
Well, what else are you going to do? Look, think of it as an investment. I want a good night's sleep tonight.
Thank you. What will we do without you, Auntie Pat, eh?
You did the same for me, remember?
Seems like a different life.
No, I can't today, darling, sorry. Because I'm up to my eyes in it, that's why. Listen, I'll have to go, but thanks for phoning. Great to hear from you. Keep in touch, yeah? Bye.
Who's that?
Oh, just an old business associate.
Yeah?
Yeah, he was in London for the day, wanted to do lunch.
Well, and you're not going?
I can't. You know what we got on at the club today.
Well, we can handle it. Well, you don't trust us?
Dennis, I trust you.
Right. Well, you can meet this bloke for lunch then, can't you?
You should be flattered knowing a gorgeous hunk like Minty's got a crush on you.
Yeah, all right.
Spoiled for choice, eh?
Andy, come on, can we just drop this now?
Watch you.
Yeah.
Well, he ain't going to be hanging around here all day, is he?
Why, drop me all to yourself?
I'm thinking of you. Can't you just get shot at him?
No, not unless you've got any bright ideas.
Oh, I'll come back to you on that one.
Morning.
Oh, no, not you again. What?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just going to go out and...
Sam, look, we are okay now, aren't we?
Yeah, of course we are. Yeah. Just let me go and help Billy out.
All right.
See
ya. Yeah. Laura, I'm off now, love.
Hey, come on.
Oh, I'm sorry, Pat. I just never thought it would end up like this.
It hasn't ended up like anything. It's not over yet.
I just can't carry on like this.
Laura, you're a bright, intelligent young woman. You can do anything you want if you set your mind to it.
Yeah. It's all very well saying that. All I ever wanted was a normal family life. Bunch of kids running around. A nice, ordinary husband. No one special. Ian would have been fine.
Darling, you did fall pregnant with another man's child.
Well... Ian had blotted his copybook long before I ever got pregnant with Bobby. So much for dreams, eh?
Darling, you're young. You've got your whole life ahead of you. There's a world of opportunities out there.
And I can't even afford the bus ride to go and look at them.
Do you know how many times I've had to pick myself up from scratch and start all over again? More times than I care to remember, and I'm still here to tell the tale, aren't I? I'm not saying it'll be easy. It never is. But at the end of the day, there's only one person who can get you out of this mess. And that's you.
He's my dad, Gary. You could have stood up for him.
Yeah, well, I tried, didn't I?
Yeah, well, not hard enough.
Oh, so it's going to be my fault now, is it?
Have you any idea what this is like for him? Jobless again, after everything that he's been through.
Yeah, of course I have. But I'm not the boss, am I?
Oh, you're right about that. No, you ain't.
What's up with her?
Oh, almonds. Look, Chaz, I'm sorry. For what it's worth, I reckon Sam Mitchell's making a big mistake getting rid of you.
What, getting rid of an old man who didn't know one end of a spanner from the other?
No, I wouldn't say that. I mean, you were ace with the punters, not to mention the old chamois leather.
Neither of which fixed people's cars.
Look, it just wasn't the right job for you, was it, eh?
Yeah, what is?
Well, I don't know, but I know you got a lot to offer.
Like what?
Well, like, it's customer service, isn't it? I mean, that's your skill, and there ain't a lot of that about these days.
Yeah, because nobody wants it, that's why.
No, I disagree. I reckon that's exactly what people want. Now, Sam Mitchell might not see it, but I know there's plenty of other people out there that will. Trust me.
Well, go on then, who's died?
We're eating.
Oh, and you've always been taught never to speak with your mouth full, is that it?
I'm just not mourning people.
I think you're going to perk up for the rest of the day because I'm leaving you lot to it.
To what?
So out of the club, what do you think?
Why, where are you going?
Business lunch. I mean, is that all right?
What, 2 days before we reopened it?
It's not a problem, we'll be fine.
Sure. Yeah.
Oh, good. For a moment there, I thought I was grounded. Anyway, I'll be back in time for the fire inspection.
What happened to the control freak? I don't know.
Right, come on, we got work to do.
Hi, it's me again. Listen, change of plan. Just got a couple of things to tie up and I'll be straight over. So drop everything, all right? Okay, see you then, bye.
We've only got a minute, Pat, I have coffee. How's it going?
Yeah, all right. I had dinner with your friend Michael last night and...
Oh, right.
He sent me this email as well.
Oh, that sounds promising.
Yeah, we're going to meet today to discuss our options.
Oh, well, let us know how you get on, yeah?
I might. Did you want something, Pat?
What are those two up to? Looks like a business meeting or something. Deserve each other.
Oh, well, thank you for holding the door for me.
I would have done if you were a lady.
Yeah, well, I can't expect the likes of you to recognise a bit of class, can we?
Black coffee, Pat, and I'd like it today, please.
I thought you were going to give me a quote.
There you go.
Oh, what are you making these sandwiches with? Gold?
If you want posh nosh, you've got to pay for it.
How much off for cash?
Oh, I don't know. I'm sure we can come to some arrangement.
This is pointless.
Stop giving up already, are you?
Who said anything about giving up?
Get in the corner, Kev.
What are you doing? You're supposed to finish that last night.
Run out of time, mate.
We are on target for today, aren't we?
It's Thursday, you're opening it?
Yeah.
Yes, but it's a fire inspection today.
Oh, right. So you want the sprinkler system up and running then?
Haven't you done that yet?
I ain't a mind reader.
Well, make it a top priority, all right?
Where's the governor?
He ain't here. We're in charge.
Alfie, have you got a minute?
I'm not going to get in trouble with authorities, am I?
No, I'm really sorry about that.
Oh, come on, you didn't ask Janine to land us in it, did you?
Hardly. I did do a good job for you, didn't I?
What, yeah, of course you did. You've got no problems with that, darling.
It's just that you said you might be able to mention my name to a few other landlords.
Yeah, right. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give them a ring round and I'll promise I'll get back to you, all right?
Thank you, Alfie. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, no worries, darling.
I'll see myself out
there. Okay. Hey, Bobby.
What are you, the local job centre now or something?
Okay, give her a break, will you, darling?
Why should I?
Because you're down on luck, that's why. But anyway, we'll really kick anybody when they're down.
All right.
Hello? No, I ain't here at the minute. Yeah, all right, I'll tell him. Cheers, mate.
Is that my phone?
Yeah. Some bloke called George. Why don't you give him a bell?
Right.
See you later.
Unbelievable.
Oh, Mr. Hendry!
Where'd you get to?
Oh, sorry, Lindsay. I had a pile of things to sort out today.
Oh, right. Nothing I could help you with, then?
No, not really.
Okay, well, I'll just be on standby then.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
Right, well, there's no forms to fill in. I go with my gut instinct on these things. Oi, you lot, come out! You need eyes in the back of your head in this place. Another second and they've had those in their bag.
But they were just trying to... I can see why you need an assistant.
So, why you?
Well, I'm observant, reliable, conscientious, I'm good with people, and I've got a very good head for business. I ran the cafe for ages.
This yours?
Yeah, but he won't be a problem.
So you could start straight away, could you?
What, today?
Well, it does say urgent.
How about tomorrow?
Yeah? Well, it'll do. All right?
Thank you, Mr. Hendry.
See you tomorrow then, yeah?
Hey, how's my little centre half this morning then?
Oh, well, you kept me up half the night.
Oh, yeah, that's no way to treat the ladies, is it, son?
I must have been taking lessons from you.
Charlie, yeah, it's Gary. Listen, mate, I've just seen something that might interest you.
Have they? Hi, you had a chance to make any of them phone calls yet?
Laura, I'm so sorry, darling. I've not had a chance, babe.
Oh, don't worry. You're off the hook. Got myself a job at the Minute Mart.
Hey, nice one.
Cheers.
Hey.
See you.
All right.
Oi. Why's she looking so happy about?
Oh, well, despite your best efforts, Janine, Laura's had a change of luck. She's landing the job at the Minute Mart.
Right, Julie. I want you operating like a bloodhound on this door, yeah? First sign of trouble, you come to me, all right?
Yeah, yeah. No problem.
So there's certain people around here who'd love to see this club go under.
No chance, yeah? Not with a man like this on the door. I'm knocking up people like, boy! Oh, that.
Right. Have you used these before?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, of course.
Right, well, check they're working, and if you need new batteries, go and get some cash from Sharon, all right?
Oh, yeah.
And nothing more.
I've got you, bruv.
Julie.
Hmm?
Don't call me that.
I'm sorry, King. Dennis. Oh, Spence, what's happening, bruv? What's happening? Come. Do me a favour, yeah? Take this and go around the corner. Go on.
And
you get to hear me on the radio, exclusive things.
Right.
Go on, Send me. Oh, man.
Well, I think it's perfect for you, love.
Yes. There's nothing like an honest day's work to nourish the soul.
All I've got to do now is sort something out for him before tomorrow.
Well, won't they have a list of registered childminders down the council?
Do you reckon?
Well, it's worth a try.
Yes, well, you will tell me if there's anything I can do to help, won't you, Laura?
Well, actually, Dot, there is something.
Julie? Julie? Zoe? You right?
Yeah.
Yeah? Cool. Listen, I was just wondering if you thought you might come to Andy's den for a party this Thursday.
Try stopping me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, great.
Here. If you want us to test this sprinkler system, it might be an idea to turn the water on.
I never turned it off.
Well, there's bog all coming out of the pipes.
What?
Ah, look! There's water in the street, coming down the road and lapping at my feet. Oh, somebody better go.
So you know there's water in the street, but you didn't think to come and tell me?
I was just testing the kit, you know, Brooke.
Jules, I'd pay you to keep an eye on things up here, not provide the cabaret.
Sorry, Dennis. Tell it! Spence! Sorry about that, mate. Technical hitch. You get me? Over. Spence! Oh. Spencer, bruv.
Hello. Look, come on, Link. Give us a break, will ya? Hello?
Him in trouble?
Yeah, something like that.
So, how's it going?
Well, I'm not being funny or anything, Sam, but it's a two-man job over the arches. Well, I'm going to wear myself out at this rate.
Oh, and you ain't got any ideas you could help?
Yeah, well, if I did, I'd be telling you like a shot, wouldn't I? Mm.
Mm. French's grand opening night.
Yeah,
there's a whole crowd of us. Anyone special?
No.
Hey, Ralphie, your water off.
Oh, some plonk has cut the main pipe in the square, apparently.
Oh, great.
Spencer, go easy on the glasses, all right? Because we're looking about a wash-up for a bit.
What's this?
Oh, that's mine.
Spencer, man, you're taking libbies. This ain't funny no more. Game over, man. All right.
Yeah, sorry, Julie. Over.
Yes, Spencer.
Here you go, mate. So, all on target for Friday?
Yeah, don't worry. You'll get paid.
Hello. One way or another.
Excuse me, mate. Is this a major problem or what?
Don't know yet, mate.
Well, how long's the water going to be up for?
Gaffer says we've got to wait for the waterfall.
And they're on their way, right?
Lunchtime, innit?
Yeah, but I need the water back on. I got a fire inspection this afternoon.
Sod's law, mate.
Oi!
That's £10 exactly.
There you go. I gather you're taking on Laura Beale.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, well, I knew someone would give her a chance eventually.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, with her history. Oh, I'm ever so sorry. I thought you knew.
What is it? Drugs?
Oh, no, nothing like that. She's been doing very well. I know that the violence, you know, it's been under control for a few months now. And, well, that business with the benefit fraud, I'm sure it was just a one-off.
The change.
It's really good of you to give her a break, you know?
Excuse me, sir. That job in the window. You're not still looking for anything, sir.
Hi, Doc. Running a babysitting service on the side, are you?
It's me good deed for the day, Sharon. Mind you, we ain't no trouble.
Never are when they're asleep. Hey, Pauline?
Well, she don't feel up to working today, so I'm on double shift.
Another good deed.
Well, when you think all she's been through.
Yeah, I know. Doc, I'd like these dry cleaned if you can manage it. Mm. They need to be ready in time for the club opening.
What, tomorrow morning, do you?
Yeah, perfect.
So, it's all water under the bridge for you and Dennis, is it?
Well, I know it must seem a bit odd, Doc, but, honestly, it's for the best.
Is it?
Here it is. Right, I'll pick these up in the morning, yeah? Thanks.
Oh, Bobby, don't cry. Mummy will be back soon.
What's going on?
Not a lot. Water crisis, love.
Well, where's Dennis?
It's a burst water main. What are you doing sitting about? Can't you get on with the rest of it?
Sprinkler system. Top priority, you said.
Look, we'd really appreciate it if you could be on our side today, please.
Since you are so nicely. Come on, boys.
We might as well face it, Sharon. We've blown it.
No, we haven't.
Well, look at the state of the place. We might as well just cancel this opening.
That would really go down well, wouldn't it?
Look, what's the score with the water main?
They've gone to lunch. Don't even know what they're dealing with yet.
Dennis, come on. Don't give up. We can do this.
Well, there's a lot to think about, Michael.
You mean, like, what to do with your first million?
Well, I've known that for years.
And why doesn't that surprise me?
Because you know that I'm a winner, like you. Well, I've just got to run this by my solicitor before we take it any further.
Cautious lady.
Oh, it's just a formality. I'm sure that everything will be fine. Pat?
Found one.
Maria Pichetti. She did the same nannying course as I did.
Well, she's bound to be all right then.
Oh, she's perfect.
Well, there you go. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
Can't wait.
So, this Mr. Henry must be paying you a decent wage.
Pat, I was so excited I completely forgot to ask.
Oh, Laura, get round there. Go on.
Right, how much is it going to cost me to get you guys back to work right now?
What do you reckon, lads?
Excuse me, Mr. Hendry, I just realised we never got a chance. Charlie?
Oh, love, what can I do for you?
What's going on?
I would have rung, only you never left a number.
And if I had have left a number, what would you have said to me exactly?
You should have told me about your past.
My past? Oh, I get it. This is Janine, innit? What's she gonna say to you?
Enough. Now, I'm sorry. I've had to give the job to someone else.
Laura, I swear to you, I knew nothing about this.
If you'd have wanted a reference, Mr. Hendry, I could have suggested several respectable members of the community that would have told you the truth about me and Janine. It's all right, Charlie. I know it ain't your fault.
Oh. Charlie, you did something about it, didn't you? Job in the window?
Oh, nice one, Gary.
Hey, where's Bobby?
Why should you care?
She thought the job was hers.
Laura! Laura! All right, dear. Arnie Doc's just come in.
Anything else?
No, I don't think so. We should be able to get this signed, sealed and delivered in next to no time.
I'll give you a shout in the morning.
Janine!
Till tomorrow, then.
Yeah, me too. That was the best lunch I've had for a long time. Yeah, we'll do it again sometime. Hold on. I'll call you back. Lost your lighter, Samantha?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I think you know exactly what I'm talking about. You owe me a club, remember?
Come on, he's going to be here in a minute.
You sure the water's back on?
Yeah, I'm sure. It was checked just now.
Oh, airlock. We're in business, folks.
Right, now get that sprinkler system checked. All right. Talk about 11th hour.
I'm impressed.
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring.
Chance would be a fine thing.
Oh, Laura.
I'm sorry I left him for so long, Doc.
Oh, it don't matter. I used to sing that song to my Nick donkey years ago. Of course, it never done the trick with him, but your little one seems quite taken with it. Are you all right, Laura?
Not really, Doc, no.
Oh,
some nice flats in here.
What, you moving out?
I'm thinking of you, actually.
Why would I want to move out?
I ain't planning on staying at Sam's forever, surely.
Why not? It's family home now, isn't it?
You got a shot on Minty, then?
Oh, only temporarily.
Just been hanging around like a lost sheep.
Yeah, well, to be honest, I've got more important things on my mind. You know, if I don't find another pair of hands for the Archers, I think Gary's going to walk.
We seem to be missing a trick here. Minty, didn't he used to work in a garage?
Minty?
Yeah.
Of course. Oh, Andy, you're a genius. Dad!
Sweetheart!
What are you doing here?
I've got myself a job, thanks to your old man.
Gary?
Yeah, he talked me into it.
Oh, well, that's brilliant, isn't it, eh?
Brilliant, fine by me.
So, how's your business lunch?
Fine.
Right.
How's the lights wide? Anyone want to see him?
Yeah, of course.
Nice.
The sprinkler is sound.
Well, looks like we made it.
Yeah, not bad for a bunch of amateurs, and the line of communication seemed to be up and running too. I'll have to abandon ship more often.
You never did have a business lunch, did you?
I achieved more this lunchtime you could ever imagine, Princess.
Mr. Watt?
That's my name.
Robert McLean, fire safety officer.
That's a good job by the looks of it.
Drink.
No, you're all right. What, am I forgiven now, am I?
Yeah, well, Dad told me that you were on the talk to him to get that job at the minute, Mark.
Yeah, well, after single-handedly getting the sack yesterday, it's the least I could do, weren't it?
No, I'm really sorry.
Yeah, you always are. I don't know what you take me for something.
Yeah, well, I'll make it up to you tonight. I promise.
Oh, sorry, Sam. Were you looking for me?
Yeah, I was. You know something about cars, don't you?
Oh, well, yeah, sort of, yeah.
Well, I've got you a job. Come here. Gary? You said the Archers needs two pair of hands?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, right. Meet your new boss.
Right.
Hi! You did that on purpose! Getting away with this.
Right. Now, you tell him what you just told me.
This bar's obstructing the fire exit. You're 5 inches over.
Ah, oh, what?
Never mind what. Just tell us what you're going to do about it.
Oh, I'll get the plans.
Listen, we've got an opening due here this Thursday night.
Not without a licence.
Oh, come on. What's 5 inches between friends?
Hey, I don't make the rules.
But you get a double-decker bus through there.
Dennis.
Joyner's got his numbers wrong, I reckon.
I don't care who you blame. I want it done by tomorrow.
Oh, I don't know about that, Squire. We'd have to work through the night.
I think we said payment on completion.
Right.
It's a tall order, Mr. Watt.
We'll get there.
Can you come back on Thursday?
Well, it's not usual practice.
Please, this means so much to us.
Ah, well, I suppose I could make an exception. But you're cutting it fine, you know that, don't you?
We know that.
OK, I'll see you Thursday.
Thank you.
You can't turn it back for 5 minutes, can you?
Oh, don't worry, Vicky. We're firing on all cylinders here. And there's nothing else Watts can't do when we put our minds to it.
Janine! Oi! Janine! Oi! You deaf or something?
Discerning, Laura, not deaf.
What exactly have you got against me?
If you have to ask, you are even more stupid than I thought.
I'm just trying to earn an honest living here.
Tough being a single mum, isn't it?
It'll cost me a fortune to get this coat dry cleaned and you're going to pay for it.
Oh, do me a favour. I'll tell you what, why don't you go down the charity shop and get yourself a new one?
Give me the money, Janine. It's the least you can do.
I'm already subsidising your existence by paying my taxes.
You what?
Well, you are still sponging off the state, aren't you?
How dare you!
I'd go for the charity shop if I were you.
Don't be scared.
We're not in love. We're not even seeing.